Yes, hello. Yes, I'm Wouter from Steffi Man's WordPress Hosting, and as he just told you, I'm an account manager. And today I'm trying to bring your conversational levels by phone to a next level. So I'm trying to teach you some new things about conversation by phone and how you could get that prospect or that client to become yours. So I'm going to give you some inside information of some of the tricks and the things that I use and that a lot of us at Steffi use to communicate with people. As I just told you, I am an account manager. I have a background of 8 years in sales. I did both business to business and business to customer. I even went door to door for a charity. That was one of my first experiences in sales. And even though it was raining, that was still one of the most raw sales I did. I went door to door for the charity and people were nagging me. They were really not happy for me standing there and bothering them in their free time. And that was one of the first experiences, but after that I was hooked. I really enjoyed it. So I went on and I did some other jobs in sales. I went to conferences and I did business to business, business to customer. And now I'm here at Steffi and I'm hoping to teach you some of the things that I was taught in all the way that I worked. If you got any questions, you can always send me an email on or contact me on Twitter afterwards, or also ask a question. Okay, my presentation. Don't call us, we call you. I'm going to start off with a case, so you can all relate to the case. Then, why should you call? Preparing your call. What should you prepare before you're going to call? Listening. Of course, listening sounds normal, but there are several ways you can listen, and it's important that you know them. How can you lead a conversation? It's really important as well. What are the right questions? Are there wrong questions? How can you build a rapport? What is rapport? What should I avoid in a conversation? So what should I really not talk about? And of course, how can you end a conversation properly? The case. Me, I'm a web designer in this case. I have minimum experience, and my normal budget for a website is 1,250 to 2,000 euros for a normal website. And the client that I'm going to talk about is John. He's a restaurant owner. And he wants a website for his restaurant. And, his budget is about 1,000 euros. And he wants his website mobile responsive. So, its budget is kind of lower than I normally make my websites for. So, that's something we can work with. First off, I'm going to start off with, why should I call? The advantages. There is less miscommunication possible compared to email. When you're emailing, you have to wait sometimes, 6 hours, sometimes a whole day before somebody's going to answer. And, that sucks, to be honest. When I'm in sales and I'm sending someone an email and I want direct contact, I'm like, oh man, please answer already. Or you misunderstand each other. That often happens as well. You have a lot of miscommunication when you talk. And when you call, you can clear the air directly. You can directly tell them what you mean. So that's also direct contact. You can have direct contact with John. When you call in the first 5 minutes after he sent in the form on your website, so he sent in the form and you call in the first 5 minutes, there's a higher possibility he's going to be your client. Also, there's more possibilities to ask questions and to dig deeper into the needs of John. I mean, if you're just going to send an email, you are only and really only going to talk over the case. But now you can go deeper. You can ask more questions. You can ask follow-up questions. And also more possibilities to build a rapport, which I'm going to come up later, what that really means and what it is. What can you do to prepare your call? There are a lot of things. When you're going to prepare your call, you should beforehand make an agenda. You should, and I just told you, you have to, the best is to call in the first 5 minutes after you filled in the form. But it's good to have an agenda. It's good that you know which questions you want to ask, which things are unclear for you. So make an agenda before the call. Also, get a laptop or get a notebook where you can write notes down. When you have a long conversation with somebody and you have to build his website, you really have to know what things are for him the most important. So get a laptop, a paper, and write your notes down. Also, get your mindset clear. I mean, perhaps you've been sitting all day, you've been sitting like this, and you're just working on this website. It's been a pain in the ass. And then it's like 4:30, John comes in, you just send in the form, and well, you just think, I really don't really feel like it, but I should call him right away. So what you should try is stand up straight and talk directly to him. Change your mindset. Be happy about it, and just go out of that sitting position. Change your position. Listening. Everybody can listen, right? You're listening right now to me. I mean, there's nothing special about that. But try to use words and expressions when you're listening to John. Tell him, okay, go on. Okay, that sounds familiar. Okay. Use small words or expressions to show them that you are really listening. Also, write down the highlights of what you're discussing with John. Like I said, get a notebook, write everything down. And that brings me to the next point. Make a summary and give feedback. Give John feedback on what he's saying. What is perfect is that John is going to tell you something like, yes, I discussed with my brother, he's also the restaurant owner, and well, together we decided we want a new laptop, and my nephew told me that you really need a mobile responsive website these days, so that's why I really want a website which is also mobile responsive. Well, there are a lot of things he's going to say. You're going to write down the highlights, and after that you're going to give it back to him. So you're telling him, so John, if I understand you correctly, you want a mobile responsive website because you saw your nephew making a booking or a reservation online at another restaurant, and you decide together with your brother, who is also one of the decision makers here. He's also the owner of a website. And never make an assumption. You shouldn't fill in things for John. You should always be open for anything. How do you lead a conversation properly? It's also an interesting topic. Why should you lead a conversation? Well, in sales, if you lead a conversation, that means that you're only talking 20% and you're listening 80%. And it is important because when you're listening a lot and you're not speaking much, it means that John is the one investing. And investment from somebody who you want to become your client is really important. You can start off with little things. Start off with the agenda of the call. Why are you calling? Well, what you can do is tell John, hey John, I saw that you filled in this form on my website, and I'm calling you because I had some questions regarding this form, and well, perhaps we can work together. That's a good start. Also, it's important to create a good conversational atmosphere. So you can build up rapport, do some small talk. Perhaps it's already the second time you're calling him, and last time he said, yeah, sorry, Wouter, I have to hang up. I have to go to this funeral. And you can ask him later, how are you today? Is everything well? And well, small talks always helps to build up rapport. You are the one asking the questions. Like I just said, it should be 80-20. John should be talking 80%, you should be talking 20%. So good questions help with, well, you being the leader. And of course, the power of silence. When you're silent, and also in a conversation with the client, he is probably the one who is going to talk, and that helps a lot. Because the one who is starting to talk first is the one who is not in control. And in a conversation, that is, well, really nice to have the control. How do I ask the right questions? In summary, ask open questions. There are a lot of yes-no questions. And you should always try to ask open questions which aren't filled in. For example, when you're talking about the budget, you know that John has a budget of 1,000 euros, and you want to talk with him about it. You want to know why, you want to know if it's really 1,000 euros. So you can ask him, John, is your budget really 1,000 euros? And he can say either yes or no. He can't give anything else, right? I mean, that's his only answer. But what you can do is say, why do we have this budget? So you know the reason behind it. So open questions, really important. Keep digging. Also ask follow-up questions. Sometimes you don't know everything, and you can, well, give some follow-up questions which help John a lot and help you a lot in knowing everything about him. And again, make a summary. What I just said, it's really important that you make the summary and that you tell him, is that correct? Did I understand everything perfectly? If you make a summary in a conversation, that helps a lot. So John just told his story, and you are going to see if what you understood from him is really correct. Always make a summary. Building up rapport. It's an interesting item. Building up rapport is, well, mainly is trying to connect with people. There are a lot of levels how you can connect with people. There is actually, you have words, you have the tone of voice. So you have my tone of voice, which is working, but you got 55% physiology. Sorry, my English isn't so well, so I think this is a hard word for me. But, and that is in person. So that means that only 45% is words and tone of voice. And those 45% you can do by phone, and the other 55% not. But that still means you can influence and that you can build rapport by phone. And 45% of that can be done. So yes, it is possible to make rapport by phone. Who are you speaking to? Show interest. Like I just told you, do the small talk. When he told you about the funeral, or it's his birthday, it's his birthday, you can talk to him and you can tell him, yes, I heard it was your birthday last week. How was it? How are you? Did you got any presents? Small talk helps with building up rapport. Tone of voice. Well, tone of voice is really important. I can talk really deep and slow, or I can talk really high and excited. And tone of voice, especially in the first call, is really important. You should be excited and your voice should be a little bit higher. And later on you can change it to, well, a little bit more of a deeper voice when you want to reel him in as a client. So you can start off, hi John, hey, thanks for calling. Thanks for filling in the form. I'm really happy that you contacted me. And that's a good tactic to let him open up and show him that you're really happy that he contacted you. Mirroring and matching. Well, a lot of people use words, things, really often they have stop words. One person I know has a stop word that is for example, but then in Dutch. He uses every time he's talking for example. So for example, I mean this and this and this and this. Well, this is one of the things that if you mirror that, he will feel like you're matching. So what you can do, you can do the same. You can use almost in every single sentence that you're saying, you can say, for example. And when you do that, he will feel like you two are matching. So you can create a bit of a bond, even though you're just talking by phone. It's a pretty fun experience. You can try it later on. These are some really deeper neuro-linguistic programming tactics. I can't really cover the whole depth of them, but you can perhaps read some of it online later. It's really fun to know about it. What should you avoid during conversations? Avoid this. Questions within questions. Don't ask double questions. just keep it simple. Just ask one question. If you're gonna ask more than one question, he's just gonna answer you the last one, not the first one. So don't do double questions. Don't interrupt John when he's talking. When John is talking, let him finish. Don't interrupt him. It's, well, rude, and he's not gonna be happy. He's probably needs to say a lot more things, and well, he can't finish his sentences, which for him sucks, and he feels unappreciated. Pitching. Well, pitching in sales is one of the things that happens way too often. John is going to ask you, yes, Wouter, I saw in your portfolio you made this and this website, and I really liked it. Can you make that for me as well? And you're going to say, yes, of course. I've got all these awesome things. I can make them for you. It's only going to be 1,250 euros. And yes, I can build it for you. But what you should do instead is ask an open question. Dear John, why do you want your website to be like this website? And he's going to point you all the things that he likes about the website you've got in your portfolio. It's a good tactic. Asking yes or no questions. I said it before with the question thing. I said, well, try to ask open questions. Don't ask closed questions. They won't help. How can you end the conversation the right way? Well, you can start off, of course, with, are there any questions left? That's like the first thing you're gonna say. John, do you have any questions left? Is everything clear for you? It's really important. You can, of course, make a summary again. Actually, you have to make a summary again. What did you discuss? What appointments did you make during the conversation? You have to make a summary of them, and you have to tell him everything that you thought you understood from him. So, if you didn't do it yet, make a new appointment. Tell him, John, we have to follow up on this. I think like in 1 week, I'm free. Come by and we will talk about how we're gonna make your website. And make an appointment, follow up. And last but not least, Annette, tell him, thank you for your time. I'm really happy and it sounds like we can work together great. And I will call you next time. Which is also the end of my presentation. If there are any questions, you can ask them.
So this is only for a sales call. Does this work when sometimes a client does call me and I try not to answer, but sometimes I forget and I pick up the phone? Does the same thing work?
Yeah, it works as well, especially the building rapport thing, the calling out the little things. If you know that the client has been busy on a new project, you can ask him for it. And it will create a bond. So yes, it does work on other things than not only on sales calls. It works on almost every call, especially the making report thing. That's really relevant.
Okay, thank you.
No problem.
I think for proper sales activities, tooling is also a very useful thing. Mm-hmm. What kind of tooling do you use or suggest for the people here to use for customer relations?
Yeah, you can use, of course, several. It depends a bit in if you want to invest or not. If you want to invest, you can buy really good customer relation management programs. And you can add everything into it. You can add agenda. You can add everything into it. But it depends. If you're just a starter, even Excel would work. And you can write down the conversations that you have. And you can do a lot with that. But there are also a lot of free programs available or free trials available at, well, some programs like PipeDrive, for example, or HubSpot. It's really new, really a good program as well. And you can create a free account there and try to start with it and see how it works for you, how it relates to you. Well, thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you all learned something.